We learned how to solve homogeneous second-order linear differential equations for d0 and d positive. But what about d negative? In that case, you get complex roots of your characteristic equation. So if you would just put them blindly into your exponent, you would get complex solutions. And that's not what we want. We are looking for real solutions. So how do we deal with this case? That's what you will learn in this video. So we have a homogeneous second-order linear differential equation with constant coefficients, like this. But now d is negative. We plug in the familiar ansatz. We get ar squared plus br plus c equals 0. But now the d is negative, so we get complex solutions. So r is of the form alpha plus or minus I times beta. Alpha and beta real, but the total r is a complex number. So what can we do then? Well, first of all, we take back basically one step. We solve the problem fully complex. Just say, well, okay, let's look for complex solutions first, computer solutions, and in the end, we will do some trick in order to get our real solutions back. But first, we look into the whole problem complex. So what would we get as complex solutions? Well, just y would be a times e to the power r1 times x plus b times e to the power r2 times x. Where now, because we are looking fully complex, a and b are both in C, now complex numbers. You can write down what those exponents are. Alpha plus e to the power beta x, you get e to the power alpha x times e to the power I beta x. That becomes this Euler's formula, cosine beta x plus I times sine beta x, so like this. And for the other one, you can do the same trick. You get, again, e to the power alpha x. But now e to the power minus I beta x, so it gives you cosine minus beta x, which equals cosine beta x, plus I times the sine of minus beta x. You can take out the minus sign to get the minus I times sine beta x. And then you can clean up some of the mess, take the combine the terms with a cosine and with the sine. So you get a times cosine beta x and then b times cosine beta x over here. And with the sine, you get again this e to the power alpha x. And we get the I times a times the sine over here and b times minus I over here. So there we are. And now the nice part is that this part is already real. This part is already real as well. But the a plus b is some complex number, some unknown constant. And the I times a minus I times b is also some unknown complex constant. And now you do a trick. You choose your constants a and b. A and b are both complex, and you choose them such that the combination a plus b and I times a minus I times b becomes real. So how do you make this choice? Well, you choose your a 1/2, c1 minus I times c2, where c1 and c2 are real. Well, that's not really restricting your a, because now you have just the real part of a, some arbitrary number, and the imaginary part as well. You just gave them a bit strange names. But now, given this constant a, you choose b in the following way. You choose b to be 1/2 c1 plus I times c2. So you can choose your a arbitrarily, the c1 and the c2, but that fixes your b. So what happens then? If you now compute a plus b, those factors over here will drop out, and you get c1. So a plus b becomes real. And if you compute a minus b, you get the c1s over here will drop out, and you get minus 1/2 I c2, minus 1/2 I c2, so minus I c2. So I times a times b becomes exactly c2. So with this choice, your y of x becomes a plus b becomes a c1 times e to the power alpha x cosine beta x plus this term over here becomes c2 plus c2 e to the power alpha x times sine beta x. So there you have a fully real solution. So over here we have our real solution y of x in case we have complex roots. So in particular, what will be the y1 and y2, what will be your independent solutions? If your r is of the form alpha plus or minus I beta, you have your alpha and your beta, your first independent solution equals e to the power alpha x cosine beta x. And a second independent solution equals e to the power alpha x times sine beta x. So that's a small example. A y double minus 6y prime plus 0, 13y equals 0. We find the characteristic equation by plugging in y equals e to the power rx, yields r squared minus 6r plus 13 equals 0, complete the square. Then you get r minus 3 squared plus 4 equals 0, bring the 4 to the other side, r minus 3 squared equals minus 4, so r equals 3 plus or minus 2i. So we find an alpha equals 3 and a beta equals 2 in this case. And we know immediately then what our solution will be. Y of x will be c1 times y1 e to the power of 3x times cosine beta x plus c2 times e to the power of alpha x times sine of beta x. Now also, if your discriminant is negative, you can solve your linear second order homogeneous differential equation. You just have to know how to find the solution y of x given your root alpha plus or minus I beta.